Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us this morning for this great occasion. My name is Roxanne Miles, and I am the current Pierce County Parks Director, and I'm going to just MC for our brief presentation this morning. I've had the privilege to serve as the Park Director just since last July, and I recognize that many, many people and many years have come before me to be able to bring us to this day and celebrate what we are celebrating today. The completion of this section of the Foothills National Recreation Trail is reason to celebrate. Not only just because you can now go from Puyallup to Buckley, or from Buckley to Puyallup if you prefer the downhill, without the breaks and the detours that have been there before, but because it also anchors so many more sections yet to come. The connection over the White River into King County that'll happen between Buckley and Enumclaw is a crucial next piece that's already in the works. The work that's happening for the Puyallup Riverwalk by the friends that are connecting and extending out of the Puyallup trailhead. The Cascade Junction to Wilkerson that's just around the corner that will continue up to Carbonado and make the connection that's been long desired. The Tacoma to Puyallup Pipeline Trail, another extension that's going to get from Tacoma to South Hill, and we also purchased the 100-acre woods, so from South Hill you can drop down into the Foothills Trail. All these things are happening because of a great vision for Tacoma to Tacoma, a vision to go from Mount Rainier down to Ruston. All of that and activity to make that happen continues even as we talk here today. As you have seen or will see, this vision takes passion, creative engineering, an appreciation for our environment, and active pursuit of matching funds to make it a reality. The bridges, the views, the collaborative efforts that went into funding this link from South Prairie here up to Buckley, it was huge. If you've gone on that section, you see what it took in order to engineer these bridges that go over the canyon, a way to give us access and to appreciate the beauty that lives between these cities. There are many to acknowledge and thank for the Foothills National Regional Trail as it stands today at this moment and still for what is envisioned to come, because all of that has been put on the maps that I hope many of you saw out in the booth area. There are many to thank and acknowledge, and I will do so as I introduce each of today's five speakers. So first, for our welcome, we'll get started with recognizing that this trail connects communities, and the mayors of these communities have become key collaborators in this vision. And as I welcome our host city mayor to the podium, I'd like to acknowledge other local mayors who have made this possible. I know that Mayor Pat Johnson is with us here today. Give you a wave, Mayor. Sean Palmer, the mayor of Puyallup. But we've also collaborated with the mayor of Orting and Wilkerson and Carbonado and the mayor of Tacoma. If we have other mayors in the audience, could you please raise your hand and let other folks see and appreciate what you have helped bring here today. So with that said, again, thank you. And I give you Stu Terry, mayor of South Prairie.
Thank you, Roxanne. Thank you, Roxanne. Appreciate that. Let's turn this around the right way. How's everybody doing today? Good to hear. I'm reminded of a story about a chicken and a pig. I know you all want to hear this. The chicken and the pig wanted to do something nice for the farmer for taking such good care of them, so they decided to make the farmer breakfast. So the chicken offers to provide eggs and says the pig should provide the bacon. The pig questions the chicken, "Why does this require you to merely contribute while I must fully commit?" Now, the level of commitment one will dedicate to a cause is clearly an indicator of its worth. And we have a whole community of people here who have worked tirelessly to bring this trail from a vision to a reality. And this trail is a result of some very hard work by many who will go out without recognition for their efforts or their pain. How many of you have attended a meeting? Thank you. Some have given time, attending countless meetings and lobbying on behalf of the trail. Some have given money. Big thanks to all of you generous donors out there. Thank you. Appreciate that. Now, in many ways, we all support the trail simply by telling others about it. This area is rapidly becoming a destination as word spreads. The increase in recreational resources and economic benefit to all the communities along the trail will help support our growing region's population. Now, today we celebrate the connection of the trail from South Prairie to Buckley. It's been many years in the making, and regardless of your level of commitment, we should all strive to being good ambassadors and stewards of our wonderful trail. Thank you all for coming.
As I mentioned, this particular section of trail required many negotiations with landowners, innovative routing, and spectacular bridge engineering to ensure that the route was safe and included the best views and natural experiences possible. The streams and the canyons that are part of this exquisite experience were also part of the challenge in getting it constructed. Can staff members who were part of this venture please raise your hand high so everyone can see your involvement? I know we have Kimberly Freeman, who is our Resource Stewardship Superintendent. Those hands still high, please. I don't know if Teresa's here, who was the park manager. Planning and Public Works collaborating on this project in order to engineer it, but also our parks maintenance staff who are out here working alongside the community to keep it active and available and safe for everyone to use. So thank you to you all. The county recently received an Excellent 10 award from the Economic Development Board, recognizing the important and impactful work that this trail has accomplished, what it's been able to bring to the local communities. Staff were honored in council chambers, and many speak to this highlight as a project for them personally and professionally that they carry great pride in and feel like they accomplished something good that they will never forget as part of their career. We know that this is a historical moment that they and their children will enjoy just like you do. And as a staff group, we are led by your county executive, Bruce Dammeyer, who has a few comments to share after riding down the trail this morning with Mayor Johnson from Buckley.
Thank you, Roxanne. This is a great day, right? Huh? I'll tell you personally, this is a great day for me for one reason, and that is that I have ridden down this trail many, many times, touched the fence, and turned around and gone back to Puyallup. No more, right? No more. I have been, like many of you, I have been waiting and waiting and waiting for this to happen. 3 decades or so, and this important connection is finally being made. I have to tell you, I was in the parking garage of the County City Building, and I was talking with Superior Court Judge Elizabeth Martin. She is the presiding judge for the Superior Court. And she had seen me writing about this trail connection, and she said, Bruce, I want to tell you that I have only ridden, I ride the Foothills Trail frequently, but only from Puyallup to Ording. And she said, just the other day, for the first time, my husband and I rode from Ording to South Prairie. And she says, it was amazing, the natural beauty. And I'm sitting there thinking, oh my gosh, how could you have missed that for so long? But she was so excited about it, about what she had seen, about riding next to the river. And then I said, so have you ridden from South Prairie to Buckley yet? And she said, no. I said, you will not believe it. And that, I am so excited to introduce our community to this connection and what it means. The engineer in me loves the engineering of the bridges, but just the spectacular natural beauty, the ability to make that connection is amazing. And like everyone has said, and you're gonna hear these words, I suspect a lot in all the speakers, this started with a tremendous vision by many people, but one person that I really wish was here, and there's nobody with us here more in spirit than Ernie Bay. Yeah, let's hear it for Ernie. As the founder of the Foothills Trails Coalition, you know, he was just absolutely committed. He saw the power, he saw the importance of trails in our community. And I am thankful that he knew this was gonna happen before he passed, but I'll bet you he is looking down on us right now today and maybe taking a lap and we just can't see him. So that kind of vision for our community is powerful. And that galvanized the coalition, right? It's the Foothills Trail Coalition, but it's a coalition that's much broader than that. I can remember being down in the state legislature as a senator and knowing, okay, here come, we got to make sure we get our state funding. There's been so many pieces of funding. So many people have stepped up at various parts to take their turn at the wheel. And I remember fighting hard to make sure we got funding for it down there. And the last thing is the sense of connection, right? The sense of community, the connection between South Prairie and Buckley. My wife was on riding the trail the other day, and she said she came across a group of elderly women riders who made a habit of riding to a place to eat. They ride to gourmet lunches, and they were so excited. They were riding up on their way to Wally's Drive-In in Buckley. So, but isn't that just cool? That is amazing. If you can tell, I'm a little enthusiastic and a little excited to be here today. This is fantastic. And I want to close with just a quick note of appreciation. I have loved riding the Foothills Trail forever, have ridden that road to Buckley many times, really am looking forward to that. But I'll tell you, one group that I want to pay special appreciation to, and they proved it this morning. Mitch and Brad, where are you guys? They're out there somewhere. Where are they? Back there. Okay, so Mitch and Brad, what they were doing this morning, after checking the trail last night to make sure everything was clear, they work for our parks department. They got up this morning and got the word that there was a tree down across the trail. So I want you to, as we ride the trail, remember Mitch and Brad and our other colleagues in the parks department are out there making sure it's safe and maintained well for us. So again, this is a great day. I am very excited to join you. Thank you very much.
Securing the funding to fund the trail is often just as challenging as trying to engineer one that crosses over the terrain that we're talking about. This project was funded locally by Pierce County, the Puyallup Watershed Initiative Active Transportation Community of Interest, and by generous matching funds from the Foothills Rails to Trails Coalition, who recently presented a big check at the County Council meeting to show their support in their match. These contributions were key for us to be able to attract a Washington Recreation and Conservation Office grant, as well as Federal Highways Administration funding. Those are the big dollars that we need to continue to bring, and because we have the local support, it happens, and it will continue to happen. Advancement of the regional trails plan across the county occurs because of both on the ground and at the top through our county, state, and federal representatives. Today we have some representatives from our county council, but if there are any state or federal representatives or people who help to secure any funding for this section of trail, we would like you to raise your hand and let people know that you were involved in bringing resources to this trail. Give yourself a high five. Well done. Yes, thank you. Stepping in for Councilmember Dan Roach, the District 1 Pierce County Council member and an avid trail supporter, who, by the way, has a video on his county website showing how he and his family uses the trail. Stepping in for him today is Chair Council Doug Richardson.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you very much. Dan really wanted to be here. You should have seen him on Thursday as he was frantically trying to get somebody to replace him at another event that he had to do. And I would encourage you to go look at that video, because it really does a great job of explaining how much this trail means to Dan. And it's very exciting to be here this morning in his shoes, so to speak, because this is Dan's last year on the county council. So for this event to happen on his way out, I know this is one of the things he's most proud of accomplishing in his two terms on the Pierce County Council. I think I'm also here because there's supposed to be at least one city slicker at every event. So as you can tell from my apparel this morning, you also should know that we're here giving remarks as elected officials, and my grandchildren are here, and probably because they know how exciting my remarks are going to be, they've never left the playground over there, and they're probably down the trail somewhere else waiting for me to catch up. I just want to thank, on behalf of the county council, all of the people that had anything to do with the day we're at today. I told them when they came to council, the coalition, that it's not often that we receive checks at the county council. Generally, we're kind of moving them the other way. So that was really an exciting day for us to receive that check. And I just want to give a shout out to how much that meant to us as government officials. You know, when you're going to go out and trying to compete for state dollars or do other things, when somebody has, you know, skin in the game that you can talk about, that they're presenting as making a project happen, it goes a long way towards getting commitment for other sources of funding. So I'm not going to say anything else other than thank you. I'm pleased to be able to participate today in this ribbon cutting, and I'm just happy for all of you that this day is here. Thank you very much.
Well, it almost feels like we're working backwards a little bit today, because we're progressively moving back towards the beginning of this trail in the vision for Tahoma to Tacoma. In this Foothills Trail, completion of this section really goes back to original vision, an original group of people who decided to put in time, talent, and treasure towards a dream to make it a reality over two decades ago. As Mayor Pat Johnson, leader of Buckley, and a Rails to Trails coalition member comes up, I'd like everyone who is a member of the coalition to raise your hand high and be recognized and seen, because I know you are responsible for the day and for most of the people who are here. You've all contributed some sweat and probably some blood or calloused hands at the work parties over the years, and you've advocated for this local, state, and federal funding, and that really has made the difference. The volunteers who ride the trail and keep it safe, clean, and friendly, as we promote on the back of the program today, really are the heart and soul, and we do salute you for your passionate commitment, for where we are here today, and for what is yet to come. Yes, if you build it, people will come, but the question is, who will build it? And you stood forward and said, we will. And you have come alongside and worked with the county and worked with others to make it happen, and we appreciate that. So, Mayor Johnson?
Well, everybody has taken my speech so far, but I would be remiss if I didn't mention the two people that were really the driving force behind the Foothills Trail, and that's Doc Tate and Ernie Bay. And if you're from the Valley, you knew Ernie. Everybody knew Ernie. But if you were from Buckley, Doc Tate was the doctor in town for years, and he delivered a whole generation of people that are residents of Buckley. But without them, we wouldn't be standing here today. They had the vision, the dream, the desire, the push, and they formed the Foothills Rails to Trails Coalition. And it's been that coalition, and I wear two hats. I've got my mayor's clothes on, and I've got my Foothillers clothes on. But it was that coalition that held the feet to the fire of the local politicians to make sure that it got done. And they put their money where their mouth was. And I think over the last several years, they've donated over $200,000 to various communities and grants as matching funds that garner extra points when we go before the legislature or the RCO board or any other board and say, look, we've got this support behind us. There are so many trails. Our main focus is getting the trail to the White River, which it is. We're working on getting the bridge across the White River to connect to Enumclaw and is Jan Mullen. Jan Molinaro was on the bike ride with us. Jan, could you raise your hand? He is the mayor of Enumclaw, and this is just as important to Enumclaw. It is an economic engine. I have often given a talk called Tale of Two Cities, where I have compared Buckley and Orting, where there's absolutely no comparison because we didn't connect. I used to ride my bicycle down that hill, and there's no way you can do it today safely, not with the traffic. So this is going to open up Buckley like it did Orting, and it's going to open up Enumclaw as it is doing to Buckley now. Wally's has seen a definite uptick in business. So our next goal is also getting the trail, other trail networks in Buckley so they all connect, and getting the trail to Tahoma, the Tacoma to Tahoma. The coalition has done a lot of work, sometimes clandestine. Nobody knows how a certain bridge got there, but I think if you ask around. But they are always out there, them and the backcountry horsemen up above Carbonado. In 2 weeks, we'll be running a relay race from the entrance to Mount Rainier National Park to Ruston Way, and it'll be coming through Orting, it'll be coming down the Foothills Trail. So that is our dream, and we're going to continue on with that dream, and we're going to keep everybody's feet to the fire. But I know Doc and Ernie are looking down on us today. They're holding off the rain, I'm sure, so we can get this ribbon cut. But no, it's onward. And Jan, we're going to get there. Five.
Well, before me, there was Tony Tipton as Parks Director, and Tony is here today. Tony, raise your hand. Right back there. And before Tony, there was Kathy Kravitz Smith, also here today. And before them was Jan Walcott. And Jan really helped start and said, yes, we will find the way. And the trigger for getting the trails plan, the regional trails plan, to map this out, not only the Foothills extension, the whole Tahoma to Tacoma, but how the whole county really could be connected. That's over 200 miles, and we really are just beginning. But almost all of it spurs off of the vision and spurs off of this link that we are celebrating today. So Jan.
Well, thanks Pierce County for getting this done, huh? Have we waited a long time? Yeah. Nice to hear him mention Dr. Tate and Dr. Bay. They should also mention Sam Colarossi. Sam, raise your hand. Just a side story, in the city of Orting, they were opposed to the trail. They were adamantly opposed to the trail. In fact, if you've seen the bell tower in Orting, that was put in the middle of the trail to stop it from going through. And then suddenly they had a turnaround, and it was Sam Colarossi. Sam, thanks for what you did there. That let us get there. Let me tell you that in January of 1986, we had our first planning meeting for the Foothills Trail in the library in the city of Orting. Even though we weren't very welcome there, we rented that space, and that's where we had our first planning meeting. Pierce County Executive Joe Stortini, Pierce County Council Member Barbara Skinner ran the meeting. And it was about 50-50, pro and con. There were a lot of folks that said this thing shouldn't be done, private property rights will be spoiled, all kinds of issues, none of which were true, at least we didn't think so at the time. But by golly, we presented them with a plan for the Foothills Trail and a plan for a countywide trail, which has already been mentioned, and over a period of years, we got it done. Over a period of years, I say, just a short 32 years ago, we started this thing. So are we glad we're here today? We certainly are. We mentioned Dr. Tate and Dr. Bay, should have mentioned a guy named Stan Engel. Some of you don't remember Stan, but he and his wife were just so hardworking on this thing. And then there was an employee of Pierce County by the name of Claudia Peters. And did Claudia do a lot of work? Claudia did the work right here in South Prairie. She was the one that was meeting with the people, trying to get them to donate or at least sell part of their property. And so it's been an exciting trip for all of you, for Kathy and everybody else with Pierce County. I wish Jim Montgomery would have been here. Jim was a director for Pierce County Parks many, many years ago. So you've already heard them all talk about where we're going from here. We're going to Enumclaw. The mayor of Enumclaw is here. That's a big deal. I hope he brought the King County executive with him. You didn't. Okay. Because that next step across the White River is a big one. I know our coalition friends are working to get up to Wilkeson and Carbonado, and we'll get it done. But getting to Enumclaw, because of what the work that they've done over there, that's the next big step on this thing. So Pierce County, it's all up to you. You're the mainstays in this thing, so don't let it go. So all of you, thank you for being here today.
All right, now, so just a few things before the main event that we've all been waiting for. A few instructions. After the event, we invite you to come back to the booth area. There are some refreshments there that are there, courtesy of Joe Mills, who has donated them to the celebration today. Thank you, Joe. Also, with the booths and tables, there's a lot of information, particularly the groups that have helped adopt this trail. The Rails to Trails Coalition, where they will be highlighting their Rainier to Reston Ultra Relay. So we hope that one day, yes, that relay, the whole thing is run on the trail that we are envisioning, and that it will still be run once that completion happens. We also know that there was a great celebration earlier today by the Rails to Trails Coalition in honor of Dixie's family and contributions that were made. And so Dixie has been a great part of that heart and soul, and we were glad she was able to honor her husband this day in that way. We also want to thank the Tacoma, Washington Bicycle Club, who helped bring folks here, led the ride coming. And if you're going to ride with them back to different areas that brought you here, if you're going back home, you can meet them in the booth area as well. But we're thankful to them. They've been great advocates and, again, rose up to say, hey, this trail is about non-motorized vehicles. This trail is about people who are walkers and runners and bikers. So let's make sure that we have those avenues to get to the event today. So now, as we get ready for our journey, we will be led by the White River Cheer Squad, who is going to be taking us in that direction back by the booths. They'll be followed by our county executive and Chair Richardson, and everyone who is here, everyone who loves the trail. We are going to be going across a footbridge that was added just at the end of the trees, and then walk up the trail to the bridge where we will be doing the ribbon cutting. Right there, really opening that section. We no longer have to touch a fence and turn around. We are going to go through that area and cut a ribbon. And we'll do that quickly. We have 6 pairs of scissors. We'll roar the ribbon out. We don't want to hold up people who are using that trail, but it'll take just a quick photo. And then making sure that we truly have this moment memorialized, because it really opened up everyone having the ability to experience some breathtaking views, something that you can ride or walk and enjoy and don't even realize that you're doing something good for your physical body, because your soul is so appreciating the opportunity to go through there.
A smile. And 3, 2, 1. All right. Yay!